always on the lookout for affordable places to travel to, but every now and then, we like to treat ourselves for a change. Welcome to Splurge Selections, a new series where we try and visit attractions that may be out of our usual budget range to find out whether or not they are worth it. In this video, we're heading to Tagaytay. Actually, Tagaytay wasn't really our destination. My family lives in Batangas and Tagaytay is along the way, so we like trying out different restaurants in the area. This time around, we're dropping by Balay Dako. Before we begin, don't forget to subscribe to our channel and ring the bell to get notified when we upload new travel videos. Hey there, poor traveler! Welcome back to our channel. And in this video, papunta tayo ng Tagaytay kasi meron tayong itatry na isang restaurant. Pero ito, kilala siya ngayon because of the view and the food. So ito yung Balay Dako. Sabi nila mahal doon, so ang gagawin natin is tatry namin to see if is it worth it or will we regret it. So worth it or regret it. So malalaman natin hopefully by the end of this video kung worth it ba talaga siya or hype lang talaga. Excited na ako, gutom na ako, pupunta na tayo doon. Balay Dako is located along the Tagaytay-Nasugbu Highway, just next to Leslie's and Philippines. If you're coming from Manila, it should be to your left. The first thing that will greet you is a spacious parking lot where a guard will give you a queue number with two QR codes, which will lead you to the digital copy of their menu and the health declaration form. Balay Dako means big house, which is absolutely fitting because it is big in more ways than one. First, it is housed in an enormous Filipino-Spanish villa. As soon as you step into the building, you'll be greeted by a roomy waiting area decorated with a massive chandelier and framed portraits. Once your number is called, you'll be ushered into one of the three vast dining rooms, one on each floor. From any of them, the irresistible view of the Taal Lake is framed by huge windows. The house is also bookmarked by verandas in case you want an unobstructed vista or an alfresco dining experience. Second, it is helmed by Chef Tony Boy Escalante, one of the biggest names in the local culinary world. Yep, the same creative force behind Antonio's, another juggernaut in Tagaytay's food scene. And lastly, it has a pretty extensive menu.
It's a combination of negrense / ilonggo and Spanish dishes. So, yun yung highlight nila talaga.
You'll be presented with a rich selection boasting Pinoy faves like chicken inasal and bok choy to Spanish-inspired raves like mechado, tayos, and pastel de lengua.
Malambot yung bok, very tender. And wala siyang anggo.
Balay Dako's best-selling dishes are found on the house favorites list. The best sellers include kare-kare classic, crispy pata, lechon kawali, sizzling bulalo, halabos na hipon, tortang alimasag, lechon manok, crisping adobong pitaw, and bistek Tagalog, among others. If you are craving classic Filipino merienda, the Filipino favorite section has the taho, champorado, ginataang halo-halo, puto bumbong, kutsinta, sapin-sapin, mahablangka, and palitaw. You can find the full menu here. On our last two visits, we ordered the following. Don't forget to try the freshly cooked piyaya. But it takes time to prepare, so order piyaya first before your meal and it should be ready when it's time for dessert. You can actually see how they cook it downstairs, right at the dining area's entrance. Aside from the dishes and meals, Balay Dako also offers deli and pasalubong items like bread, jams, dressings, curds, and gourmet sardines and tuyo. Where is the best spot? Well, the spot near the huge windows if you prefer dining indoors and the veranda if you prefer dining outdoors. Balay Dako's wide windows and spacious interior foster a breezy atmosphere, promising a delightful dining experience.
Yun. So most restaurants naman along the Tagaytay Ridge are known for the spectacular views of the Taal Volcano and Taal Lake. Ganun din siya. It's not an exception. In fact, sobrang ganda ng view nila. Maganda yung position nila. Kitang-kita mo front and center yung biniti ang malaki ng Taal Volcano. Very picturesque. Yun yung talagang pupunta mo sa Balay Dako. Bukod sa food, it's the ambience and the view.
If you happen to visit during peak hours, those spots might be occupied already. When is the best time to go? On a weekday to avoid a crowd. But if you can't avoid going on a weekend or holiday, visit during lean hours, which is before or after lunch or dinner. Check the weather too. If you are coming for the view, make sure to go when there's a low probability of rain or fog. The big question is it worth it?
Ang tanong ay, is it worth it or do we regret it?
Balay Dako might be on the pricier end of the spectrum, but the view, the service, the food, and the overall experience are all worth it. Parking on busy days and hours is just a minor inconvenience. Actually, the establishment has a spacious parking area, but the waves of regular guests and curious diners during lunch and dinner hours are proof that Balay Dako is one of the favorite dining places in Tagaytay.
Ella, worth it or regret it?
Worth it.
Ako rin, para sa akin, worth it din siya. For the reasons that I already mentioned. Yun.
In our next videos, we'll be taking on other restaurants in Tagaytay. Don't want to miss those, so don't forget to subscribe and ring the bell to get notified when we have new uploads. If you need more information about traveling around Tagaytay and other destinations near Manila, you'll find comprehensive travel guides with sample itineraries on our website www.theporttraveler.net or check out the links in the description. If you have questions, sound off in the comment section below. You can follow us on Instagram, TikTok, Facebook, Twitter, and YouTube. Just look for @thepoorttraveler. You may also tune in to the Poor Traveler podcast on Spotify and Apple Podcasts. That's all for now. Remember, plan smart, travel safe, and make every food trip worth it.